My name is Patrick Autissier. I'm from France originally. And so here we're at Boston College in the immunology lab working on HIV and SIV. And my role here is to run the flow cytometry facility. It's a technique that allows us to identify different subsets of cells in the immune system to monitor the disease, to try to find a way to reduce the infection. I was born in Paris. We stayed in Paris for 15 years, then we moved in the center part of France. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a vet first. The study for veterinarian is very tough. It's like here in the US. And so I realized very quickly that I didn't have the level. So I switched to medical school, but I failed the big exam at the end of the first year. So I quit med school, of course. And then after that, I worked for 2, 3, 4 years as an assistant nurse. But then I realized that I didn't want to do that for the rest of my life. I mean, I could do better than that. So I started to take evening classes in biology. After 10 years, I got my engineer degree. And that's where things started with the flow cytometry. When I did my engineer thesis, it was in a lab, I mean, like this one. And I got in touch with the flow cytometry techniques for the first time. It was a huge machine, I mean, much, much larger than what we have today. And I got fascinated by the technique. It has lasers, fluidics, electronics, computer. I got really fascinated by how it works. I didn't understand anything at that time, but it got me involved in this technique. And eventually, I mean, it pushed me toward learning about this technique and how to use it to do science. So that's how it started. So this machine helps you identify different subsets. And without this, we wouldn't be able to know everything we know now about HIV and other diseases. We apply this technique for HIV research here, but I mean, it's been applied for cancer research, for any type of immunological disease. It's a very complex instrument. You need to know not only the biology, but I mean, what's behind the machine, how it works, I mean, how to make things better in terms of analysis. And so usually this type of machine is run by only a few people, people like me, who has the expertise, because the more people, if you put more people in front of the machine, don't know exactly how it works, I mean, you will run into trouble very quickly, because it's a very sensitive instrument. And we finished a big study last winter, and so at every time point you receive blood, and then you stain the blood with different antibody panel to dissect the immune system to see what's going on during infection. So that's what I did last year. I want to do something else than just the technique, than just the flow. And so I have my I run my own project, and I help other people running their own project too. Well, the more people involved in research, the better it's going to be. And if people are very interested in science and want to do science, I mean, that's fantastic. And then if we have the tool for that, I mean, they can come up with ideas, with new ideas that we might not have it. And then we work together. Try to get involved in science, technology. I mean, I would say to the kid, I mean, start early. Try to get involved in any in the science community, and then after that, you learn. I mean, it's one step after the other.